A nation state is not about development, it's about welfare of people. Post-90s, India is not anymore a welfare state. India is a multinational corporation state. And all politicians are pimps of this multinational corporations. That is the reality. And we have all become, there is a price to all of us. It's not that our price tag is seen visibly.
No.
So fishermen, they don't have a price tag. Nobody is, they don't bother because if they are killed, nobody bothers because they don't have a price tag. We have a price tag, so we are left to live.
See, your effort to make their voices reach the whole of India, whole of the world, you think this effort of yours is going to benefit them in any way?
Of course, when this film was taken to Durban International Film Festival, UN Human Rights Commissioner Navi Pillai watched the film. And she was not aware of Indian Tamil fishermen being killed. She is the one who is instrumental in writing UN statement against Sri Lankan government's war crimes. But she watched the film and she wasn't aware of the issue. When the issue was taken to her, she promised an intervention. She said, I will take up this issue. And you take this to, various other international film festivals. The issue gets its due attention, and fishermen lives, there are no lives right now. Now we are creating a value to that life, a national value, an international value, so that there will be some intervention. Somebody will do something to save their lives. Even if one fisherman's life is saved, because of this film or because of, see, you come and I talk about fishermen issue to this media because we have a film. Otherwise, there is no, space where I can speak about it. So something will happen. That is the only hope I have. And it'll happen. We live only on hopes.
We are going to watch the movie and, we're going to see it. But then after this movie, what is your next step after IFFI? Are you working on new projects or, same issue, or what are you exactly going to do?
I've worked on a couple of scripts. But right now I'm with this film because I'm also trying to theatrically distribute the film. Because it has to reach wider audience. Now it's in the festival circuits. But I want to take it to the streets and take it to the theatres, take it to other countries. And it has now been added to the UN End Violence Campaign. And it's going to Hague, to the Human Rights Film Festival. So it's just not a story. It's people's lives. So we have more responsibility towards that. But still, I've worked on a few other scripts and I'll be moving on to other projects. Once I feel it has reached its destination. Yeah.
Lina, we wish you all the best and all success for you.
Thanks
for talking to me.
Thank you.
Welcome to Ghazali. Your film is being screened for IFFI. How does it feel coming to Goa, coming to India with your film?
For me, it was excellent because it was my first time in India. And everything was new for me and everything was exciting for me. Well, I knew about India, by reading, but to feel the people, to feel the atmosphere, if I was floating in the air, in a way.
Tell us a little about your film, My Australia.
My film, first of all, is based on autobiographic. It's my personal story. And it is about children which live as Catholics in Poland. And they become very anti-Semitic. And actually their mother was a Jew, but she was hiding it from them. But when they became so much anti-Jewish, she couldn't stand it anymore. And she just take the children and emigrate to Israel. And the children now have to deal with emigration on one side and with self-identification that changed completely in a very critical age, of 12, 14, when a young boy is actually building up his personality. So that's the drama with a lot of humor.
Normally what we say is, you know, at least in India, we have this, you know, typical Bollywood movies with a lot of masalas. But when somebody goes out of the way and takes a story, which is a common man story, it's a little difficult when you go for shootings, you know, when you're actually in the production stage. Was it difficult for you too?
It was this difficult, first of all, to raise money for film, which is an independent film. With the amounts of money that you have to limit yourself or to cut your script that will fit the budget.
Fit within the budget.
Yes. In my case, it was co-production with Poland. So it makes it a little bit easy because film was shot partly in Poland, partly in Israel. And I felt that if I would have another 3-4 days, I would work more on the art. But this way that we work, it was just to save yourself and to make the film, actually. But it's always much more pleasant to work with a big budget and with all the luxury of the crew.
Film has been screened 3 times in IFFI, and a lot of people have liked the movie, and they're, you know, talking about it. Have anybody come across to you and, you know, told you or, you know, given you any feedback about the movie? Good or bad?
A lot. It was so heartwarming. First of all, for me, it was very curious if the audience here will accept the story. Mm-hmm. Secondly, it was interesting for me if they would catch on the details. Mm-hmm. I would always enter the cinema, mm-hmm. actually, to watch the audience. Here, and they were laughing on the right place, and they were, and after the film, and even when I was crossing here around, people were approaching me, and it came to a superlative that some people told me it is the best film I have seen in this festival, and it was very heartwarming, because, you know, I am coming from a different part of the world to this part of the world with different culture, and. You know, it's like a literature. When there is a human story, it works everywhere. Yes. And it catched here as well. And it was a big pleasure for me.
Since India is known for Bollywood masala movies, even when you, before you came to India, you must have heard about it. Yes. Were you, at the back of mind, were you scared or you had doubt about the movie?
Not really, because, you know, I was reading about India and I knew that the people are very intelligent. So I knew that they would come over, you know, all the stigmas there, which are accepted, and they have their own opinion. So, and it worked that way, actually.
Tell us about your projects, earlier projects, and your future projects, what you're looking forward to.
First of all, I was doing a lot of documentaries film. I think over 40. And this is my first feature film. Well, I did docudrama before that also, in few films. And I would love to make a film in India. And I was actually approached by some producers here. And there are beautiful story because a lot of young people from Israel are coming here to relax and they are staying for long then. And there are beautiful stories about their meeting with the different culture and the adapting part of the Indian culture. And some of them are bringing friends back to Israel with them. So there's a lot of stories who can be turned over to a beautiful film. So I hope it will come.
When we visit a new place, we always take some learning from that place because it's a new culture, it's a new language, new people, you know, everything is completely different. What is your take-home package from Goa, India and IFFI?
I think, first of all, is manners. That people, except when you go on the road, then the manners stop. there's a lot of things that, you know, I have to process them. I think I am now floating with the excitement of the place. I cannot really summarize what I will take out from here because everything is exciting for me. I said to somebody that, like in India, everywhere, if you put a camera for 3 hours, you have a story without moving it, because things are happening. And the other thing, you know, I took a scooter because I want to go to see the village, to feel the people. And one of the things that was amazed for me, that usually in a strange places, when a foreigner is coming, he is suspected. And over here, people were accepting me with a smile. And it was a big pleasure. It's like they are not afraid, and they welcome you in a way.
Thanks a lot for talking to Prudence.